Hello, everybody. Welcome to this stream. Welcome. Okay, yeah, we're back. And we're here for some more story stuff. We're going to be doing some side stories here today in Punisher and Guerrero Raven. Namely, Dungeons and Dragoons. And yeah, without further ado, let's go. World of the Brave. The warm wind has brought you a message across the rain in the hidden realm of dragons. Yes, this is like a D&D scenario, pretty much. One seal, the ancient triangle is now lost. Lee turns on his terminal to simulate tactics and take records. As adventurers, you have embarked on a journey to the hidden realm to retrieve the lost artifact. Hey, Neon Willow, welcome to the chat, welcome. Good, I'm good, how are you? Well, Lucia is using a terminal to assign different stages of the mission. Hey, this isn't a mission briefing, it's an adventure, just relax and enjoy it. This is the second story I drafted. I asked Chang Yu for some key elements about Kowloon's Dragon Boat Festival and incorporated them into the script. But I wanted you to enjoy it rather than think of the script. Just leave the performance part to me. I mean, you will hardly get to sit together and play games like this. So what are the rules this time, Isla? Rules? Just do whatever you like. You don't have to stick to role-playing this time. In other words, we will be playing ourselves. Playing ourselves, Considering the personalities they rolled last time were cheerful, gentle, and lovely, honestly, I think I did my best. Time to pick our starting location. Literally D&D. Simulated D&D. Port City Wilderness, which one shall we choose? From an information gathering perspective, I suggest we pick the city, for there should be a library or an academy inside. We can also find more supplies. Alright, good to hear too. Good that you're doing alright, Neon Willow. After seeking approval from everyone, you reach out and tap the icon marked with city. Before you can touch the option, its frame becomes grayed out. One moment, please. Isla opens the control panel to check the game's status. Synchronized gameplay on. No connection error. Player quantity. Found it. Someone else has joined the game. They were so quick. I only just published a game script. Must be veteran players. It seems you can only choose the port now. As long as it's not the wilderness. Better make the decision before the system throws you into some unknown corner. Starting location, Southern Port. The guide screen disappears completely. The slowly expanding graphics have wrapped everyone's mind, gradually descending into the world sketched by Isla. Yeah, more Punishing Ray Riven, yeah. Yep. We're back. Relentless waves struck the shore, bringing a cool scent. In the middle of the day, masts are swinging in the distance under the hot sun. Seagulls spread their wings, roaming and guiding freely along the never-ending coastline. Definitely a peaceful and beautiful beach view, if only one can enjoy it from a normal angle. If the terminal screen is working properly, we are currently in the air. Clouds and birds fly past your vision. The ground is rapidly increasing in size, a hint that you are descending at a dangerously high speed. I've never seen anyone land like this. Oh, parachute. Isla, no, DM, I want my find my parachute as soon as possible. Sorry, but such service is not provided on this flight. Protect command at first. We are constructs. We should be able to land on the sea surface. Legit D&D. Oops, what are you talking about? Novice Lucia from a swordsman family? There's a village under us. Watch out! Liv's voice is torn apart by the howling wind. A group of villagers are gathering right underneath. Aw, thank you. Thank you so much. I'll appreciate the compliment. And I appreciate you joining me. Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you. I really appreciate that. I hope you really enjoy me reading these stories with you. And I hope you enjoy me reading this. And I hope you keep enjoying them. Me reading these stories. At least. But to Grey Raven's surprise, before they can crash to the ground, an invisible force gently holds them up midair. The team lands safely after a little hovering, only to find themselves overwhelmed by the cheering of the crowd. What? They try to find out what's going on, but all they can hear are irrelevant phrases like heroes, savior, or crisis. A man walks forward and bows to Grey Raven. He seems to be the leader. Greetings, heroes. Thank you for responding to my call. I'm a traveling wizard. When I came past this village, I noticed the villagers here were in dire need of help, so I made a summoning toward the sky. The man who claims to be a traveling wizard then turns around and stretches out his arms. Ladies and gentlemen! Behold, the heroes who have responded to my summoning. They have come to help. Aww. Before he can finish, the impatient villagers have already swarmed forward, pushing him to the ground. Please help us, heroes! Heroes! Mighty heroes! He pushed the crowd and run away. Fortunately, everyone in Grey Raven has decent stamina. The traveling wizard becomes exhausted, but after rolling a dice, you are able to carry him to another place. Inside the room, the squirrels are running up the table legs with teacups on their heads. They put the drinks in front of the guests. Then each takes a candy from the jar. The four Grey Raven members are sitting around the table, watching the traveling wizard wiping something off his hood. A large shoe print, to be precise. So what would you like us to do? I haven't really thought about it. I mean, I haven't been so lucky for a long time. Lucky? I mean, every summoning is like a lucky draw. Getting four heroes at once is an extremely rare event. What? Legendary! The traveling wizard makes an exaggerated croaky exclamation. He seems delighted. Why did he summon us here? If there weren't many heroes that responded, I was thinking about asking them to run errands like collecting firewood, picking up deliveries, or clearing a clogged toilet in the neighboring village. Bro, seriously? Basically, D&D plus isekai is what I'm getting from the story. People don't often ask others to perform these tasks. True, only fools would do these jobs. But you are the famed heroes. You weren't serious, were you? I don't mean to offend, but could you prove your identity as the Summoner of Heroes? Summoner of Heroes? In the name of gods, please trust me. I mean, I was there to greet you in the first place. I stand by justice and integrity. I changed my mind after seeing this large team of heroes. I want to see you to save the world. Even the squirrels have stopped making noise. Time seems to have frozen. Everything has gone static until a breeze moves the curtain. Can I have some responses? Yes, I'm listening. Keep going. Mission objective to save the world. Save the world? But how? You need to find the legendary ancient triangle, of course. An ancient triangle? As you saw earlier, the villagers came to me for the same reason. Before the ancient triangle appeared, monsters often attacked the villages until heroes brought back the replicas of the ancient triangle from the Real of Dragons. But all the replicas have gone missing now. Real triangles? Is that supposed to be a Legend of Zelda reference? Is that supposed to be a Legend of Zelda reference? Would you like us to go to the Realm of Dragons to retrieve new replicas? only to put on the graves of this village. What a brilliant idea. I mean, there's no way you can make it in time. You may as well just collect the materials required to make them. I can make them a new replica as long as I have enough materials. One moment, please. I need to jot it down. Materials to craft a new one. Is there any chance of failure when you make this replica? I don't quite know, but I have tried many times in my journey, as it is as reliable as it can be. So there's still a possible chance to fail, isn't it? Nobody's perfect. Recommended to prepare 3 times. No, 4 times the materials required, just in case. Okay, what's next? Lucius Sirius Saltatukes makes the traveling wizard give up the drama and finish his speech as soon as possible. The replica consists of 3 parts. The first is twin souls, which can only be brought out from the realm of dragons. But worry not, I've already borrowed one from nearby town. The next is flawless rope. I got some from the black market, but there's only 1 left.
It is a possible, the triangles could possibly be a Legend of Zelda reference, considering the Triforce is in the shape of a triangle, and it is a legendary ancient artifact, so, I mean, it's entirely possible that it is a reference to Legend of Zelda, maybe. As for the soulless body, I have nothing left. Fortunately, we can find the material to make it nearby. Ordinary people won't be able to get close, but you are heroes.
Okay. Well done. Alright, let's go. Time for do some stages.
Follow my lead. There's nothing to be afraid of.
Monster waiting at the destination? I see. Who told you I'm a monster? I'm the mountain god here. Okay, Mr. Mountain God. You want to collect bamboo leaves? Be my guest. Take as many as you can carry. It's just my grumpy neighbors might not welcome you. Okay. There seems to be the bamboo leaves the wizard mentioned. Be careful when picking up the leaves. Don't break them. Still less than required quantity. Go find more bamboo leaves. There seems to be more over the bridge. Alright, let's go. Don't look at me. I'm no match for them.
You dare get in my way! Go ahead and struggle, you piece of junk!
Alright. Here we are. I love this story. Oh, this story is a nice, lighthearted one. I love it. Very D&D. Woo, woo! Alright, buddy. Not the best, but not the worst. All right. Come on. There we go. Seems you picked up all the leaves here. Let's get across the river. Man, this is great. All right. Boom. Case is full, we did it. Did you hear any weird sound? Woo woo. Oh, so that's
pretty wild. My time is shot. Whoa, 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 over already? I was just getting warmed up.
Hey, let's go. I'm liking the story so far. I like it. Sorcerer's Plan. It is a very ordinary title. tile roof. Basic, simple, with no decorations. With the wizard's help, Grey Raven members now have transformed into the childhood looks, lying prone and side by side on top of the roof. Ten minutes ago, the traveling wizard was made speechless when he saw the crates full of bamboo leaves. To ship the materials back, he borrowed the largest boat in the village from the fishermen. Still, he underestimated Grey Raven's ability. Did you take all the bamboo leaves from the mountain? Sorry, wizard, I forgot the boat had limited space. I reserved some space for you to hide in the boat. I mean, we need to go past the ferry, and I don't think you want to be surrounded by villagers again. Actually, don't worry. I used my alteration magic to turn you into children, so you can hide inside the crates. That also solves the problem. After throwing 4 successful rolls, Grey Raven becomes Little Grey Raven. But the traveling wizard never explained what the problem was. Just before the team arrived at the traveling wizard's temporary workshop, the villagers somehow found out where they were. Almost the entire village rushed to see their heroes. Alright, gotta have a good look, lurk, Neon Willow. Have a good lurk. We've got all the materials ready, folks. Rest assured that the crisis will soon be resolved. The traveling wizard holds the bamboo leaves up high, trying to convince the crowd to leave. What, where are the heroes now? Overwhelmed by the noisy crowd, he has to scream at the top of his lungs to answer them. The heroes have gone back to the mountain. If you want to thank them, just wait in the village. It's true, I swear, they were right here. Traveling wizard points to the roof to make himself more convincing as he makes an oath. The crowd has finally left. The traveling wizard collapses to the ground. Thank you, traveling wizard. Liv peeks out from the roof. After feeling the villagers' extreme passion and hospitality, Grey Raven dares not show up directly in front of them. No problem, I just didn't expect you to reject the honor without even thinking. We didn't help the village for that. That's exactly why I would like to thank you once again on the behalf of the villagers. We don't have much time left. Where are you going next, heroes? Like what you said, there aren't enough materials outside the realm of dragons to make replicas of the ancient triangle. Correct. If we can solve the problem once and for all, we would love to give it a try, but we need a replica of the ancient triangle to enter the realm of dragons in the first place. So we want to go to the capital and get all the 3 parts needed first. Great. Besides, we also collected a lot of materials from the bamboo forest. Once you've taken the portion you need, we'll give the rest to the other villagers in need along the way. After all, the forest is too dangerous for non-combatants to enter. That's fantastic. When are you going to head out? Like, right now? Hold on. I think we need to settle our rewards first. We didn't help you for the sake of rewards, but if we can get what we deserve, I'm sure we can help more people in the upcoming journey. Oops, I almost forgot. I saw the mountain god give you a large bag of gold coins. We must have completed some tasks along the way. Now I understand why the villagers force you to make an oath. That's a scammer, huh? Oh, don't say that. I was just comforting the villagers on behalf of the gods. You mean lying the name of gods? Eh, get called out. The name of gods, I didn't lie. You sure about that? The traveling wizard holds his head up high, as if it is one of the few things he can take pride in. Anyway, here's the hero's journal that records all the related information about the realm of dragons. It's been revised by many generations of heroes and can definitely be of help. The traveling wizard holds something up high that resembles a notebook with many pieces of paper inside of different sizes, just like what he described. Its surface has been modified many times. Liv stretches her hand as much as he can, but cannot reach the notebook with the child's body. Lucia has to hold her lower body so she can extend a little further to grab the hero's journal. The traveling wizard then strikes a pose to wave a silent goodbye. Thanks for giving it to us. But this is just the amendum at the bottom of the list of rewards, isn't it? The traveling wizard crouches down as he prepares to run, pretending he didn't hear you. Of course. Immediately leap off the roof. Roll a dexterity check. Because you've been shrunk to a child's body, the DC difficulty class is very high. The dexterity roll is successful. Hey, let's go. The traveling wizard takes a luck roll. Yeah, this is very much D&D and Baldur's Gate, I feel. Alright, Commandant lands from above and pounces on the traveling wizard. Grabbing his robe, however, he quickly unties the robe, gets away, and disappears in the bush. Commandant, shall we catch him? Of course, he ran away with our rewards. The team is about to go after the wizard, but something unexpected has caught up to them. Lucia tries to land, but ends up falling on the grass. Why? Oh, shit. As your bodies are shrunk to children's, you lose all attributes and any action that requires a check that has the difficulty double before you get used to the new bodies. Let me try. Roll. Rolling, check, failed. Little Liv stumbles upon her own feet, falling next to Little Lucia in the exact same way. Lee, would you like to give it a go? I mean, there's no ladder nearby anyway. Don't worry, I'll cut you from below. Thanks, but no thanks. Commandant, don't forget you're also a child now. Such action has its risk. Isla, I'll roll a check. Little Lee falls backward off the roof before he even starts to jump. We've trusted him too soon. Maybe we are the problem that he mentioned earlier. Isla, is there any way we can dispel this magic? Only those with the corresponding spell can do so. For example, a powerful wizard. If the hero's journal was passed down by previous heroes, will it contain the information they left? Surely there must be some powerful wizards among them. Liv opens the notebook and soon finds a hand-drawn map. Oh, here it is, the path to the capital. Commandant, we will go past the nameless sage along the way. Isla, what does the writing about this nameless sage look like? Looks pretty new. It almost has not faded at all. Let's go there then. We need to transform back to our original looks first. Alright, let's go. Let's go. This has been a pretty fun D&D experience so far, I won't lie. Anyways, Chaos of the Capital. Isla gives her room a quick cleanup, then sits back and awakes her terminal. She stares at the screen as the game world's time flows. She did her best to reconstruct the elements of this world, for example, the sea breeze that was blowing the stand, based on past records and documents. Alright, time to keep working. I was the one who invited them, after all. As a member of WGAA, Isla is extremely skilled at creating game worlds. Let me summarize the progress first. Once I consolidate all the players' results, I can design the upcoming changes. Isla clicks the open world archive. The adventure team that spawned in the city is shown on the top. So these are the players we found earlier on. Good, let me check what's happening over there. World influence factor is 17.31. Amazing, they just started the game and had already done something that could influence the entire kingdom. Isla eagerly clicks watch to peek at what's going on in the capital through a terminal screen. Okay. Unlike the sunny shore, the sky is dull and gray. It seems to have also impacted the pedestrians as they walk past with forlorn looks. Numerous pieces of paper fall from above. Soldiers who are riding fantasy creatures are grabbing the paper pieces from baskets and throwing them out. Isla pauses the screen and zooms in. The content on the paper is very simple, a poorly sketched brandishing portrait with a line of text. Oh shit. Notice of execution. Oh shit. Eilis searches the crowd and finally finds the player team in the center of the execution ground, guarded by many soldiers. Three of them are individually tied to three stakes, with firewood under their feet. Looks like they do not have much time left. Oh, Strikehawk! I said we didn't do it! Please trust us! Please trust us! Compared with Chrome and Wanji, he has a lot more ropes attached to himself.
Shut up, just give us some rope, will you?
Like I said, we didn't do anything. You're just not listening.
Where did we catch you?
The artifact room.
Was there anyone else in the room when you sneaked in?
No.
Where was the artifact stored?
In the cabinet?
Is the cabinet now empty?
I think so.
Alright, we have all the evidence and witnesses. The criminal has confessed to the theft of the artifact. Light them up.
Hey, I didn't admit to anything. Kamui begins to shake his body again, making more squeaking sounds between the ropes and the stake. I need to struggle. I need to keep taking this action. Failure, 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 failure.
Damn.
Don't move.
After wasting all the ropes, the soldier ties Kamui up with a steel chain. He pulls both sides of the chain and kicks the stake hard to tighten him up. DC to break free increased. DC to break free increased. DC to break free increased. I don't care. I keep struggling with all my strength. Wait, why am I the only one rolling that's rolling dice? Do something, Wanchi.
Bro is asleep.
Inspecting Wanchi of Strikehawk, he's sleeping to recover spells. At this point in time? Kamui shakes Wanchi in real life, whose eyes are all closed, only get the reply that nothing else can be done. Excuse me, could I have some water, please? I don't want to die thirsty. Contrary to the farce in the center of the execution ground, Chrome remains in the corner and calls the soldier guarding him.
Just wait, I'll get you some.
Great, thanks. The moment the soldier walks past the corner, DM, I want to take out the knife that I hit earlier and attempt to cut my rope. No one's watching you. Success. Your progress is...
Hurry, another chain is to seal his mouth.
You can't do this to me. At least let me say my final words. When the soldiers turn their backs against Kamui, he peeks in Chrome's direction. The rope is quietly coming off, just like he thought. Just a little longer. Somehow, Kamui feels like he has heard this Dungeon Master Isla rolling a die. Ahem, the royal family has decided to start the execution early due to poor weather conditions. We don't want the rain to put off their fire. The heated crowd bursts into a deafening cheer, as if throwing stones is not enough to calm their anger. Soldiers holding torches are getting restless. We don't even know what your artifact looks like. This makes no sense. I want to appeal. Kamui tries to argue, but his futile attempts only stirs up endless insults. The crowd seems to have lost all sanity after hearing about their crime. Calm down, guys.
Shut up, recruit. Put more firewood under his feet to burn him harder.
DM? Progress 50%. I no longer try to conceal my action, but use all my strength to cut the rope instead.
Hey, what are you doing?
Ignore him. Chrome focuses on breaking away while calculating the escape route. To his surprise, the soldier is not even shouting at him. A figure suddenly appears from above and lands on the stake behind Wanchi, crushing it into pieces with the warhammer. Hey, Karenina, let's go! Spent so long making this weapon. Never thought the first thing I did with it was to cut a stake. Karenina, why are you in this game? This is WGAA's public project. Isla asked us to help her finish the script. Honestly, I'm not good at this, so I've been making weapons at a place.
Who are you?
Soldier throws his torch away as he pulls out a sword. The torch rolls down the road and finally comes to a stop near Kamui. Kamui makes three rolls in a row, trying to kick it away, but none succeeded. The dice just hate me today, don't they? If that's the case... Hey, you over there, you dropped something. Damn, I want to use my mage hand to pull that sword close. Kamui rolls a critical failure. Damn. Try to grab the sword's hilt with a magic hand, but accidentally sneeze. The hand elegantly sends the sword flying into a crack in the floor. The soldier's nervous look immediately disappears. Infuriated, he grabs Kamui's neck and shakes him vigorously, stating that he just bought the new sword. Soldier rolls a will check, critical failure. He jumps over and disappears in the crack, following his sword. Crow manages to break free and lands on the ground with a thump. Someone immediately throws him a weapon. Here you are. It took us a lot of effort to make it in that volcano. Hey, let's go. You obtained weapon, St. Elmo, +10. Oy, scythe. Damn, I want to cut the ropes on Kamui. But Kamui is wrapped in layers and layers of reinforced steel chains. I'll just break the stake then. Roll it. As they're busy getting Kamui out, they hear the sound of multiple bows firing. A shadow dashes out from the crowd and knocks down all the soldiers from behind, then rushes to Kamui before the rain of arrows falls. Hey, Kamu, let's go. Kamu holds his great sword horizontally and uses it as a shield. Arrows land on it and make clanking noises. The next time you want someone to run away alone to seek help, better get someone else to do it. There's an emergency, thanks anyway. What do you do now? More soldiers come rushing to the execution ground. They're all differently equipped and look like an army that was just put together. Damn it, too many of us went with the expedition team. Come here. I want all my soldiers to head this way immediately. Hurry, let's get out of here while they're still in chaos. Just a reminder, don't take the wrong direction. Hey, Teddy! Like our two teammates who are confronting the soldiers, Teddy chose to sneak all the way here. Teddy of Engineering Force has activated a wall spell. Checking. Success. Transparent ice blocks rise from the ground, forming a solid wall, making the soldiers quiver in fear as they fall back. An officer has to shout at them to force them to go back holding their weapons. The spears and swords cannot even leave a scratch on the wall. Even warhammers do not seem to crack it. This crystal is less than 10 centimeters thick, but it's stronger than bulletproof glass. I tested it. We just need to take care of the soldiers on the other side now. Okay, let's go. Plot twist. Let's go. Oh, max unit 1. Okay. Let's go with Noctis. Let's go. We have to break through them before we get sieged. We solve the problem once for all. Let me finish them all. Soldiers ahead. Engineering force members, get to cover.
Started.
It's done here. Press on before they get fully recuperated. Okay, jeez. I've recovered a bit. Started to deprive sniper support. Okay, then. Damn, they're dying so quick. The road is blocked. We got some smart enemies out there. What says that? Okay, then. Guess don't really need him, then. Alright, let's get you free, buddy. Damn it, it's a flash magic. Watch out, they're still around here. The enemies behind her are catching up. Do something with your blast hammer. We made it. Where to go next? Hurry up, into the alley. Okay. Didn't really get to go. There's a crossing ahead. We take a left and then turn right to the right and move forward all the way to the end of the square. I no longer see any soldiers. Have you already scouted this place? No way, I didn't have time. I just remember that the order when DM was describing the directions. Alright. You have to come to an unknown quiet alley. The road in front of you splits into two ways. You need to decide whether you want to go left or right. DM, we will need abilities related to hearing if we go to the right? No. Alright, we'll head to the right. Using the help system's bug to detect if there are any enemies ahead? How smart. Keyword detected. Adjusting the help system. Oh, shit. Don't say it out. Haven't you realized that Isla is just an AI here? Oh. Okay. Team quickly moves into the narrow alley, going through crossroads after crossroads with ease. When they finally get to an empty ground with no buildings, they find themselves already on the other side of the city. Teddy throws some fabric to the three rescued members, covering their faces. Hurry up, let's go before the chaos spreads to here. They'll paste our wanted orders all over the city. Three Strikehawk members put on fabric on their heads as hoods, but a pedestrian happens to notice them. Before the situation worsens, Kamui pulls down his hood and puts his hands together. He approaches the pedestrian with a brilliant smile. Hey. Oh, dear friend, are you interested in learning about the Church of Flying Ramen? Bro. The pedestrian looks shocked as he's never heard of any church like that. He quickly moves back, then sideways after bumping into a wall, staying away from Strikehawk as much as possible. In a forest about 4 to 5 towns away, Graveriven is marching forward in a great struggle. Through the hero's journal, they were able to find a home of an ex-hero. After spending almost everything they had, the sage finally agreed to dispel the magic that turned them into children. Hey, let's go. Finally, back to myself. Lucia rolls a success. I want to move the blade sheath from my shoulder back to my waist. Liv rolls a success. Commandant, you're next. Commandant rolls a failure. What? Will something bad happen? It wasn't a critical failure, so nothing happened. Okay. Good, hurry, I need to roll again. I can only cast high-level spells 8 times a day, and I just used up all of them. God damn it. Silence quickly spreads in the hall. Lee, Lucia, and Liv all look down, staring at you coincidentally. Shall we just keep going like this? No. I can't go back to the capital like this. But there's nothing we can do right now. Liv squats down to the same height as you. She gently pats your head. Aw. Maybe I can carry Commander on my back. You just need to concentrate on the tactics. Can we have something normal? Actually, wait, surely something can be done. Please, Mr. Sage. I can cast a fast growth spell on you, then you can grow back yourself. Okay. Okay then. Well, damn. This door is pretty ridiculous. I love it. Sage's Confession. As Dragon Ball Festival draws near, Graven marches forward on a vast plain and finally arrives at a village near the capital. It is the 8th village they've been to. When looking beyond the forest in the distance, the majestic buildings of the capital can already be seen. But right now, they have something else to do. This is the 8th crate that Graven has given out. Each time Liv gives a crate full of materials to the villager chief, she is met with the same response. You don't need to pay us. I mean, we only want you to use them in the right place. Although still holding it back, the crowd begins to cry out in awe. To them, gathering bamboo leaves and forest forest full of monsters definitely is not easy. Among the villagers' thankful messages, Graven quickly bids farewell to them to avoid being surrounded again. The nameless sages have been waiting outside the village. This is already the 8th village, Madame Liv. I'm worried that you will end up giving all the materials away. Would you like me to keep the materials reserved for entering the realm of dragons on your behalf first? We didn't really reserve any materials. I almost forgot, but even if we have given everything out, we can still return to the starting point and collect again, can't we? The Nameless Shades looks at you, hoping you can persuade them. I agree with their decision. The Nameless Sage lets out a sigh. I'm just concerned that recollecting materials would waste too much time and make you miss the best window. Best window? Each year, this is the best season to search for the Realm of Dragons, because the chance for the realm to appear is the highest during this time. We learned this from many generations of adventurers. Chance to appear? I just looked it up. It seems to be a common setting in fantasy worlds. The mission's target area is right there, but cannot be observed due to some reason. Are you implying that area will hide by itself? You can say so. Besides, the monster in the north here have been getting a little unsettled. They may come down at any time. Restless. The young people were talking about it not long ago. Some large scary things had appeared in the northern wilds and slaughtered other monsters. You open the hero's journal left by the traveling wizard and find the real dragons located inside a large red circle underneath the northern wilds. You also notice the nameless sage is looking a bit strange. What's wrong? No, I'm just worried that the monsters would invade the realm of dragons directly if we keep wasting time here. Rest assured that we will get there as soon as possible. Really? That's fantastic. When are you going to head out? Like right now? Well, regarding this, we still need some help from you. You said we would be rewarded. We can pick a magic item to our liking. Perhaps I did say that. Fine, what do you need? Something that can be used on items to track the approximate direction of the Realm of Dragons. Are you sure? I don't have anything from the Realm of Dragons with me. All twin souls in nearby towns have been used up in making the replicas. You may not have any left. Oh, shit. Whatever, you can still try your luck in the capital. There should be some replicas of the ancient triangle from the Realm of Dragons left there. Nameless Sage takes out a staff from his robe as he speaks. You nod to Lee. He takes the staff and begins to identify it. Staff of Detection. It can point out the approximate direction of the original owner of an item. Lee takes a glimpse at Lucy and Liv. You all spontaneously move out and stand in 4 different corners. Lee then takes out the robe he took from the traveling wizard earlier and puts it over the gem on top of the staff of detection. He releases his hand, letting the staff fall. The gem points at the nameless sage, who quickly looks at the force behind him and moves aside. The staff rolls on the ground and points at him again. The nameless sage dodges again and pretends to look at the plane behind. He's trying to deceive us. Lee, Lucia, Liv, and yourself all begin to smile as you watch the nameless sage dodging over and over again until he stops. You must be tired. Do you need some rest? Thanks, heroes. I think there might be some problem with the staff, so... Don't worry, we have a lot of time. This time we can take it slow. Flash magic! Blinding flash bursts out from the nameless sage's hand. He leaps up as the team temporarily loses vision. I immediately use the enchanted necklace magic protection that the priest in the last village gave us. Lucia! Lucia rolls a dexterity check. I want to use the lucky ring given by the villagers to increase Lucia's chance of success.
Acknowledge. Calculating the result. Lucia rolls a critical success.
Hey, let's go.
The nameless sage has a head-on collision with Lucia Seath. He falls on the grass like a fly shaped slapped by swatter. Isla rolls another luck check for the nameless sage. Fortunately, he did not pass out from the bash. How unfortunate.
Huh.
The nameless sage unconsciously holds his arm up to cover his face when the team approaches him.
Gotcha, even you even my evil-minded agent.
I'm no agent. I'm the sage who summons heroes to help their people. I've never lied to anyone.
Aren't you the traveling wizard?
What traveling wizard? I don't know that guy.
Wow, this guy's bad at lying.
Just like you, he's a hero summoner who has never lied to anyone. The one made us fall from high above, asked us to do a lot of tasks for him, and ran away with all the rewards and some materials.
And turned us into children because it was easier to hide, so he can easily get away.
Commandant said we ought to beat him up if we ever got to see him again.
I suggest you confess.
All Graven members are on an intermediate check. The results are success, 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 and success. Seeing the four smiley faces, the name of Sage feels like the world is spinning around him. He's terrified and shakes his head.
Hey, get wrecked.
You can't do this to me. I used to be a hero like you. Then I took an arcane missile to the knee.
Skyrim reference, bro.
Bro, the Skyrim reference. Ask for rewards.
Fine, I'll pay.
The nameless sage cancels his camouflage spell and turns out to be the traveling wizard himself. He puts 10 gold coins in line in front of you.
There's gotta be something else.
The traveling wizard took out another 5 gold coins to compensate you.
Aw, yeah.
There's gotta be something else. Traveling wizard took out another 1 gold coin to compensate you.
Literally nickel and diming this guy.
There's gotta be something else. Hey, enough is enough. I'll show you what I have in my sleeve. The traveling wizard suddenly points to the sky, shooting a flare-like light ball upward. It then explodes into fireworks. Calling all former heroes, come help me, my friends. Soon another small and similar light ball rises to the sky from not far away and explodes into 3 mocking faces with their tongues out, along with a spell that delivers a voice message.
You deserve it.
What do we do now, Commandant? In the flash of an eye, the traveling wizard twists his body from an impossible angle and kneels to the ground, as if he and the earth had become one.
I'm sorry, mighty heroes. I promise I will never, ever, never, ever do this again.
Just surrender what you earned from the frauds.
I'm terribly sorry, but I've spent it all.
Oh, boy.
How?
Because the orphanage needed a lot of money.
God, what are you doing? No, help!
Search his body with force. Commandant rolls success. There aren't many coins left on him, but a letter of appreciation with childish drawings on it catches your attention.
Looks like he didn't lie this time.
Still, what you did was not right, Mr. Wizard. You're supposed to pay them out as rewards, no matter what you want to do with them. You need to seek approval first.
I had no other way out. The orphanage would go bankrupt if I didn't do that.
Graven members exchange looks with one another.
That's not true, Mr. Wizard.
We can waive our portion, but you must return the rest to the others.
But I don't have that much money.
Then tell them the truth and try to talk with them.
If they can't accept it, you should work hard to earn more coins so you can pay them back.
The traveling wizard doesn't answer immediately. Instead, he stares at Liv and thinks for a while, then lets out a sigh.
Fine, I give up. I've never met any heroes like you.
Good, I hope you can keep your promise.
Hey. You no longer have any reason to stay here. After a short discussion, you decide to continue heading toward the capital. What are you going to do? To finish our unfinished business. Like you said before, we're going to save this world. Fine, I asked you to do it, so I should provide my help too. Besides, maybe you can really find that place and enter it. What do you mean? It's been a long time since anyone ever got inside the realm of dragons. How about a real transparent deal? I'll provide you with real much-needed help, as long as you can do me a little favor. So what did he get into this time, or is he being bullied? The sun shouting has scared the traveling wizard. He immediately bounces up from the grass. A few well-armed adventurers rush out from the forest and gaze at Grey Raven. He must have gotten into trouble again, sigh. Ever since I knew him, he's been doing this nonstop. Dear heroes, we used to be heroes too. Can you please return him to us after beating him up? Bruh. let's go. Wow. Oh boy. Classic. Each other's trouble. Let's go. Inside an ordinary building to the left of the capital gate, Strikehawk and the engineering force have been trying to leave the game for days, but neither has succeeded. Okay. So they decided to stay undercover around the safe house for the time to come, awaiting an opportunity. Thank you, kind adventurer. May I know where the Church of Flying Ramen is? But Kamui just waves and casts aside the additional rewards. No problem at all. To thank the almighty Flying Ramen, all you need to do is live a good life. Lord doesn't care about anything else. Kamui puts his hands together and bows. The villager follows him to do so. Lord doesn't care about anything else. After waving goodbye to the villager, Kamui asks DM to check his own status and finds himself many levels higher. Hey, let's go. DM, I need more strength. I want to put all the attributes points earned from level up on strength. Wanchi watches the villager walk away. As Kamui's helper, the XP is also rapidly increasing. A few soldiers are coming their way. Kamui quickly pulls Wanchi's arm, gesturing him to lower his head and walk forward with hands together. Live a good life. Lord doesn't care about anything else. The soldiers display no signs of tension or aggressiveness. Instead, they also put their hands together to chant the somewhat awkward prayer. One of them is even holding a wanted order to check in against everybody on the street, but no one would have imagined the evil criminals on the order are walking past them as friendly and helpful members of the new church. Sir, your cape is touching the ground. Oh, I didn't even notice that. Must be because I was walking at the back. Thank you. Praise the Flying Ramen. Live a good life. Lord doesn't care about anything else. The soldier soon goes around the corner, feeling relieved. Wanchi knocks on the door of the safe house. Okay, Kirini has reinforced this thing with a broomstick, wood blocks and table corner, and charcoal tongs. What should I call it? Just call it a reinforced composite door. Someone is knocking on the reinforced composite door, making clink, thump, and bang noises. It's me! So open the door, you need to roll a check. Bruh, for real? Why do you need to roll for this? I took out the door hinge to make it even stronger, and now it has to be pulled up and down and open. It seems to have failed. I'll do it. I'll lift the reinforced door all the way up with my mighty strength. Roll! Kamui rolls a critical success. Critical success? What will happen? Did Kamui strip the door off and put it back after coming inside? One sec. I need to think. When Kamui enters the room, he finds a minor fault in the door and reinforces it to make it even sturdier. Are there still lots of guards near the gate? We might be able to break through, but one of the merchants that Kamui helped mentioned a large space under the gate. DM has probably prepared a mighty opponent for us there. When do the guards usually patrol the area? The captain said they have more than doubled the number of guards. They search the entire city once every morning, noon, and evening. Number? 8 squadrons, according to the patrol officer. Equipment? Regular army equipment, according to the blacksmith in the old North Point. Well done. Good work. Yeah! Speaking of which, does anyone remember the arrival of new heroes we saw on the notice board? An adventurer told me the hero team named Graven was also coming to the capital. I don't understand. How did you make these people... those people tell you everything? Oh, we've been helping people in the name of Kamui's new church. As long as you put the hood on and lower your head, you may even walk all the way to the palace with no issue. Which means the secret church needs to keep going. Yeah, we can secretly level up while collecting useful information. Let's not waste time and find more tasks to do. In the name of a flying ramen! What's wrong? DM just made me roll sound or perception luck. I hear steps, a lot of footsteps. Once she lifts up the corner of the curtain and immediately rolls a luck check, the arrow only takes a few hairs off of him. Break the door! The soldier kicks on the door with all his strength, making a loud bang. He then screams even louder in pain. Blow it up! The soldier seemed to have stacked something up against the door. Everybody in the room is rolling dodge checks except Karenina, who just stares at her own work, doing nothing. Boom, the loud bang that shakes the entire house watches over and deafens you. What the heck is this ugly thing? We need healing spells. Hurry! Still, the reinforced door shows no signs of breaking. Get the battering ram here. Officer, why don't we blow up the wall next to the door? Everyone immediately rolls dodge and luck checks. Only Karenina notices something is not right. What's that sound? Another loud explosion leaves the hole in the wall. Amidst the dust and smoke, soldiers flood into the room with their weapons unsheathed. More soldiers come in with sharp blades, forcing the players into a corner. Alright, let's go. Ten minutes ago, when Graven entered the capital, a guard found out they were heroes and immediately reported to the gate officer. The wanted orders were attached with magic and could not be torn off, so the guard just carried the entire notice board over. Cunning devil? Furious... Roche Beast. Officer, what exactly are they describing? Oh, dear hero, you must have not heard of him. He was an incarnation of fury. There was nothing but one nail left under his stake. If his friends came a little later, I say he could even lift the stake up and run away with it. Sleeping thug, deadly wrath, beast of destruction. Are they all wanted? Yes, my hero. Alright, tell the guards to get ready. We will head out right away. Do you know where they are? We're heroes. We'll figure it out. But as a gate guard, I must report to the guard headquarters first. Wait. Traveling wizard puts an arm on the officer's shoulder, lowering his body. He then pretentiously looks around and lowers his voice. Are you sure you want to do that, giving all that merit away? What do you mean? Think about it, they sent you here to guard the gate. Do you seriously believe they will give you the credit? I'm pretty certain that the headline of tomorrow's notice board will be something like, General XX and heroes have captured all the criminals, while your name will only show up in a corner. The officer takes a gulp and looks at him helplessly. After the traveling wizard encourages him again. He finally makes a decision and walks back to the gate. Have I seen him somewhere? Oh. Wasn't he the gate guard when we were still heroes? Or that poor guy going after someone's butt because he defrauded the Merchants Association?
Shut up, let's go. Someone seems to have recognized me. While the officer is assembling his troops, the traveling wizard winks a gray raven and blends into the crowd, walking out of the capital with his friends. Okay. Right, just like the hero said, the criminals are all hiding in them. Two familiar faces are peeking up from behind the soldiers. Lucia, what the fuck are you doing? But Lucia is standing too far away and cannot hear. She only smiles and waves at her. You feel the criminals managed to get away last time, but now I have these heroes with me. Best surrender if you don't want to suffer, my heroes. Liv of Grey Raven has poured out sleepy fog from the magical bottle. Check completed. Here's the results of reaction. The fog too really sneaks into the soldiers' noses, like slithering snakes. Some of them could not even lift their weapons before falling asleep. Hey. Critical success. The wizard's item sure did help. As she speaks, the four Grey Raven members walk up to the soldiers, take their weapons, and throw them aside. Hey, let's go. They also turn the soldiers around and search all over their bodies. When they cannot find any more items related to the mission, they lay the soldiers together neatly. How many times have you done this? You've met quite a few not-so-friendly people in the quests. Liv wanted to reduce casualties, so we came up with these procedures. Wanchi, I need to know the size of the remaining gate garrison. Gate garrison. I'll roll a long-distance scout. The result is success. Wanchi peeks through the window and realizes that there are a lot fewer soldiers guarding the game. The remaining soldiers are also preoccupied with managing the entry and exit of regular civilians. Well, Glory Even has taken away our biggest trouble. Time to plan our next step. This guy didn't report to his senior, but rushed here with his own troops. Somehow this gives me a familiar feel. Oh, hey, Noctis. Hey, ho! Ata! Critical, kill, critical, kill. Super critical, level up. Boss, I just beat up another wave of enemies. Really? Keep going, as long as you can accumulate enough power before the game ends. Speak of which, boss, that weird old man you beat up was talking about how you wanted us to save the world. Do we need to check over there? Just leave it to the Grey Raven Commandant. It's more experience than being a hero. Number 21 spell bonus. I can't calculate. Just don't calculate them. Let's check the nearby town for notice boards. Wow, boss. The Expedition Army is coming at us. Expedition Army? I've seen their leader somewhere. Right. Isn't he from Dark Ares? Oh, Simon! Are you the monsters on the wanted order who have occupied the Northern Wilds? Yep, what can I do for you? This game is designed for a script. Alice said I must play my role. We are the Expedition Army from the capital. Surrender now, monsters. Your end is nigh. You sure? Show them what you've got, Knocked. Knock. Alright. Alright. Noctis first reluctantly stretches his arms, but when his bulky body is promptly displayed, he makes a smile as brilliant as the midday sun. Noctis of Cerberus, character level 99. Sorry, I hope it didn't disturb you. Shit. Oh shit, bruh. Well, damn. Just borrowing. Alright, let's go. After a brief exchange of information, the players begin to discuss their next step in the safe house. At this moment, Graven has one of the parts required for the ancient triangle, soulless body. The Ilish Journal also explains how to get the other two. So our priority right now is to find the remaining twin souls in the artifact chamber, right? Are we going back there? I think the people there already remember our looks. I don't think we can break through so many soldiers with sheer force. Besides, Flawless Rope was outside of the capital. I think the best plan is... Tonight I will head to the artifact chamber. We'll just try to avoid the guards. Strikehawk and Grey Raven can go get that flawless thing back.
Since we're going to infiltrate the chamber, we don't need many members. Besides, we don't have information about the other side, so we should allocate more forces there. I see. What do you say, Grey Raven Commandant? That plan sounds good. Don't worry, this may sound incredible, but Kiranina and I actually work together alright. Kimori also mentioned there were many enemies, and it would be impossible to break through. Sending four members would only hinder the operation. We're stealing something after all. Most of the gate guards have been taken away by the officer and are still sleeping in the corner of the city. The remaining guards are too busy to notice a few players crossing the wall, who even complains about the lack of wall maintenance and how slippery it is. Seeing Strikehawk and Grey Raven have gone out of the city, Kiranina and Teddy fall back to the alley, using the clock tower's chime as cover. They disappear into the shadow of buildings. As always, everything is going very smoothly, just like what Ayla has witnessed in the past. Hey, let's go. But this time, there's no smile on her face. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's do it. This is the artifact chamber. Teddy, are you sure it's not a sewer? Unless the guards of the capital love to stay in a sewer. Alright then, let's go. Kiranina, the train here is complicated. Kimori and his team have been here before, so it'd be better to leave it to them. No, we can handle this. By the way, is it really a good idea to a really good place to store things? Alright. Seems you can knock away the enemy away from this angle. Outsider! Get wrecked. Oh shit. Ty, you can't come back up if you fall. Boom. Hey, let's go. Alright. Alright. Literally just beat him up all. All right. Boom, there we go. Is the mission objective in the box? Whatever, just take all of them. Okay, let's go.
Whoa, 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 over already? I was just getting warmed up.
Hey, let's go. Overlord, okay. Alright, let's go. After leaving the capital, the players follow the hand-drawn map in the hero's journal and reach the area they've never been to. Lee opens the hero's journal. Although it's largely unorganized, the information about the flawless rope has been thoroughly put together. What the journal says about the rope is the overlord of the Unbound Realm, leader of the Wings, who established Utopia in a land where no gods could see. What does that sound like, the description of the final boss? What is Ayla trying to tell us? The Nameless and Crownless are deemed to lose themselves in the storm. Nameless and Crownless, do we need to collect something? I think the naming and crown here refer to titles, and they have to be of the highest rank. Lose themselves in the storm. I haven't detected any related weather conditions. Perhaps it's just telling us without the proper title, we will be significantly disadvantaged in this battle. Ta-da! Hey! Kimori points to the top of his head with a big smile. He already has some text back there when everyone's in the capital. Pope of the Church of Flying Ramen. I was saving it for negotiation. Never thought it'd be useful here. Now I have the highest title of the Church of Flying Ramen. You only need to become my believers. This effect should be able to cover all of you. Before they realize it, the team has already arrived at the stairs. With no hesitation, Kamu takes the lead, followed by Kamui, Chrome, and Lucia. Okay. Everyone walks up the stairs. When they step onto the large platform, the door behind them shuts completely. The howling wind pours scorn on the insolent thieves with furious might. Endless lusts are shattered above the boundless clouds, falling into speckled land with their crumbled bodies. Nothing decays in this land, for the fierce winds will never lose their way. Nothing lasts forever, for the untamed wings will leave their gravestone behind. In front of you stands the Overlord, like an eagle that soars the sky. Okay. Was that an astounding enough? Hey, Celica! No, it's very astounding, already, thanks. DM, please don't use the appearance of outsiders to build character models. I'm not an outsider, this is me! Celica, why are you here? Because I'm the boss, boss! I just wanted to join his hero, but Isla said Overlord Celica was way too powerful and must not be part of the hero team, but in the hero team. Let me take a look. Open the system panel and check the character attributes of Overlord Celica. He shows maximum in every single attribute. Isla probably wanted to give the boss more protection. I mean, you can't have the characters with higher attributes than the boss in the beginner spawn point. Fair. Shouldn't heroes be so powerful in the first place? Heroes with ultimate destructive power, huh? Anyway, I can only be the boss here. Celica winks and all players see Overlord Celica written in glamorous font in their vision. Okay then. Show your health bar then. Let's enjoy this battle. Speaking of which, Celica, aren't you... You're going to draw your weapon? Celica shakes her head and only snaps her fingers. The world has begun to change. You know what? I came up with so many cool ways to send you back to work. This is a battle we can't afford to lose. Agreed. Let's go. Oh shit, okay. Yo, character model Celica, okay. Actual in-game model, oh shit, okay. Guards of the sky, follow my will. Bring the intruders down. Not today.
You dare get in my way!
Idiot! Bet you didn't expect this.
Come on, keep them coming.
My time started. The countdown of despair.
Chariots of the Sea God, unleash the waves of retribution upon the world. Shit.
Go to hell! Ridiculous. You can kill me.
All right.
Starting the countdown of despair.
Boom. Shaka Laka. Come on. Hit me again.
Kill me!
Hit me again. There we go.
Started. The countdown of despair. Have you come to die? Blow you to heaven. Go to hell.
Boom, shakalaka. Boom.
started. The countdown of despair.
Boom. Okay. You lasted longer than I thought. You aren't bad either. How about we let the next attack decide everything? Are you really going to launch one attack? Of course not. I take great pride in this job. Celica snaps for the 14th time. Endless waves are flooding toward the players like unstoppable cavalries. Hey, let's go. The music. Chrome. Chrome rolls a success. Chrome raises his output to maximum, unleashing coolness that pierces through the waves and turns everything ahead into an icy river. Kamu! Kamu rolls a success. But a much stronger force collides with them without hesitation. After a deafening boom, one carriage is smashed into pieces within an instant. Celica curls her index finger one more time before the crisp pound sound hits once again. Wanchi! Wanchi rolls a success. Hey, let's go. Wanchi's sniping goggles reflect a glaring flash. A bullet whistles through the air, hitting Celica's right hand. Although it's wrapped inside his shield, her relentless attacks still come to a pause. Lucia! With sparks around her feet, Lucia crouches and charges like a swift cheetah. She seizes every opportunity to slide her blade through the weak points of all Treants. Commandant! She grabs her hand just like she once did. You both look into each other's eyes with a smile. She then tosses you towards Celica. You've been holding your attacks for this very moment. Let's go. What's that move? Commandant Missile? Missile? There's only one shot. Launch skill! Assassinate! Calm down, you won't even leave a scratch in Celica's infinite HP. Launch skill, steal! You recall the skill that the traveling wizard taught you. You glide past Celica. Reach your hand out. Success, you obtain the eider and flawless rope. Hey, this is so much like Kazuma. You see the ground rapidly approaching. Collision is inevitable. Roll a luck check! Roll a luck check! Critical success. Commander performs emergency brake, followed by a somersault and a perfect landing. Hey, let's go. All the available attributes show that Grey Raven and Strikehawk have exhausted all their strength. I must give kudos to you, Task Force. Even if this is only the calculated result of a game program, your coordination is flawless. I should also give you the utmost respect. This will be my final strike to end the game. Spirits of the Ranging Winds, please return to your celestial dwellings and ring the Bell of Judgment. Celica's spell summons magical glowing spots around her that begin to spin rapidly. Boiling storm clouds are swarming down. Wouldn't this be a little too infuriating? It is a reasonable tactical decision nonetheless. That being said, what are you mumbling about? Nothing. We just activated the teleport spell. Bye. Wait, I spent a lot of time preparing this finishing move. You can't do this to me! Stop! Yes, I can. At least give me a proper ending. I'm the Overlord. I don't want to appear on the script like this. Sorry, but no matter how she screams, the magical glowing spots show no signs of stopping. Continue to gather around her. Finally, a light pillar shoots up and takes all players away from the danger zone, leaving only Celica behind in a daze. Let's go. Ding dong. A visitor has arrived outside the lounge door, triggering the bell. Oh, is Commandant back? Lucia walks to the door and presses the button. A familiar figure rushes in and hugs her. Help me, Isla. I don't want to be featured on the screen like that. Where's Isla? She went out with Commandant. Celica turns to Liu, sitting on the couch and studying the game. Was that your idea, Li? I was only using my resources in the most optimal way. Still, you're not supposed to play the game like that. How despicable. You heroes are so mean. You're standing in a corridor of WGAA. Isla takes out two cans of drinks from a vintage drink machine and hands one to you. I never knew WGAA had such a device. Oh, it was only recently restored, so we placed it here. Such devices were created in the Golden Age or even earlier. WGAA loves to see them in use. You pull the ring on the can's lid. The aroma of the soda drink immediately flows out. Isla looks around to confirm there's no one else. Commander, do you think it was logical for task force members and engineering force to move separately in the game just now? Why do you suddenly bring this topic up? Remember, I was checking on Karenina earlier. It took me a lot of effort because I wasn't familiar with the landscape. But maybe it's just my wishful thinking. After all, I'm not a member of the task force, and my understanding of tactics is limited to creative works only. Where do you think the problem is, then? Since I'm talking to you, Commandant, I'll just be frank. The engineering force had made an appearance previously. It was only logical for them to challenge Celica. Greyraven should be going to the artifact chamber instead, because they've never shown up in the capital. No matter how well Karenina and Teddy could work together, it was too dangerous for them to go alone. That was quite risky indeed. But Karenina also had a point. Maybe she just didn't think that much, given it was only a game. There's so many things I need to consider. Why are you so concerned? What if your most is none of my guesses were correct? They just prefer to stay with those from their own squads. I'm not saying that there's a problem, but each time I try to ask them for opinions, they always tell me that they want to spend holidays with their own squads. It just makes me feel a little lonely. What do you want to do then, Isla? I think we can try to make some changes. That's why I have a favor to ask of you.
Okay. Okay then. Alright. This is a pretty fun story, I won't lie. This is a really fun story so far, I won't lie. Alright, on to the next one. Unique Quarrel.
Red, blue, and here. Are you done yet? Boom, the distraction caused by the runes in Karenina's hand and to boil. When they finally break away from the constraint, Karenina is engulfed in a dust blown up by the explosion. T-E-D-D-Y! If magic really exists in the world, you would probably be the worst user. Bruh. I heard an explosion over there. Go check it out. Let's go to the next place.
Okay.
Karenina pulls Teddy up. Both of them had disappeared in the complex alleys in a corner of the capital. After he left the artifact chamber, someone soon found out that the artifact component had been stolen. The disappeared city guards were also found, making the situation even worse for the two of them. We're getting cornered. What can we do? Who would have thought all of the guards had come out to search after realizing the artifact was stolen? We didn't steal it. We borrowed it. We're heroes. Heard someone breaking the chamber of artifacts to steal again. Is that why they closed the gate? When the two of them walk around a corner, they happen to hear a conversation outside the tavern. I heard after the Expedition Army went out, monsters had come south and infiltrated the defense. They began to appear outside the city in groups. Oh gosh, my relative is still hunting outside the city. I have to go look for him. Do you hear that? The rendezvous point is Stagnan Valley, the only path toward where the Realm of Dragons is located.
I remember that name. There were hardly any living things near that valley, as if the world had stopped moving around it. Usually, monsters also would also follow certain rules during migration. They can't deal with human towns. Oh, are you going to sleep? Are you sleepy? Niamula? If you need to go to sleep, go to sleep. Appreciate you. And I appreciate you stopping by the way. Since they cannot find enough food near Stagnant Valley, there's a high chance since there's a dance. The monster will keep going south, bringing doom to anyone who attempts to search for the realm of dragons. I think now is the time for some emotional plot, like somebody's going to sacrifice themselves. Let's go stop the monsters then. We heartily agree with each other. Indeed, what do we do now? Shall we go somewhere else and keep trying our explosion? I mean, teleportation spell? Teleport spell? You have a point. Better do something I'm familiar with. Where do you put the red liquid? Meanwhile, where Graven and Strikehawk are. After teleporting away from Overlord's area, they feel like they have fallen into another world. Contrary to the lively environment, they only see fallen leaves and withered plants with their branches desperately stretching toward the sky. Lee, are you sure we're in a different space, not time? Liv quickly flips through the pages of the hero's journal. According to the journal, the realm of dragons was very unique weather and its climate. Some regions can be very different compared to the outside world. Did we just accidentally get to the realm of dragons? We should be in the outer area of the Stagnant Valley. Now we know how this place got its name. What's wrong, Wanchi? Do you hear those sounds? In the distance where the sky meets the mountains, the players can vaguely see a large patch of lush green color descending. After a quick scout, Wanchi puts away the weapon stand and jumps off the rock. Those things will arrive in approximately 30 minutes. We don't know the details, but based on the scale of falling plants, they'll be enlarged in size and quantity, and definitely won't be easy to deal with. Are they from the same direction? I didn't observe any other movement, but I can't rule out the possibility that there may be some creatures that are good at disguising themselves in this world. Grey Raven Commandant? What do you think, Chrome? Sorry, Chrome, but I'm going to do what Isla asked for now. I believe we should intercept and distract the targets here. We can't let them run into Kiranina and Teddy before the problem is solved. Alright then, just an air daily mission to protect an engineering force. Let's roll. Why are you still wasting time here? Kiranina suddenly shows up behind a rock and enters the communication. Sinkamoy is already geared up for a battle. She just stands in front of everyone and throws you a box she took from the artifact chamber. Here we go. What was the name of that thing? Twin Souls. Anyway, we'll take over from here. You guys should continue moving toward the mission target. Just the two of you? Would it be better if you let us task force do it instead? No, we need to save our main force for the key mission target. That increases our chances of success. As Kiranina turns down Chrome's suggestions, she starts taking out small bottles of explosives, lying them on the ground to count and refill. Teddy also moves over to help her. Lee and Chrome also squat down at the same time. After exchanging a look, Lee decides to speak first. Leaving more numbers here also increases the chance of success. If all of us can safely survive the attack, we can start our search with full strength, which will increase our odds of arriving at the Realm of Dragons. If I recall correctly, the probability to observe the Realm of Dragons fluctuates over time. Now's the best opportunity. We cannot guarantee the probability will not rapidly decline later. I believe we should focus on existing resources first, before striving for things beyond our control. We should follow this principle to allocate manpower when the situation is still largely unknown. But the argument continues. Neither side seems to want to give up on their plan. Commandant? Lucia pulls your sleeve. She seems to want You to stop the imminent quarrel. Wink at her. What? Stop! Everybody stop! After finishing the setup, Karenina bounces up impatiently. Didn't Alice say this game was supposed to be a movie script? Wouldn't it be nice to highlight the theme of sacrifice here? No, I think it's more crucial to feature the team's collaboration here during the protection mission. Come on, I just can't talk sense into you. Protection mission? What do you think where we are? Useless weaklings? Stop excluding us. We're the engineering force. Engineering force! We are the engineering force. We're fully trained for combat and do not need your extra protection. You are the ones who are excluding us. Sacrificing yourselves for the sake of us? Are you insane? With hands on her waist, Karenina confronts Kamui, who is leaning forward. You can almost see their ears and tails rising. Oi. Kamui. What? Both turn their heads to stare at the origin of the laughter. Isla's shoulders are shaking as he's trying hard to control her volume. Sorry, couldn't help it. Karenina and Kamui, you're just too cute. But we're almost fighting. Then do it. I'll be the judge. Better than all that politeness before, don't you think? Her gentleness smile smooths out the tension like the morning sun. Kamui and Karenina breathe out at almost the same time. They look at each other and shrug. No wonder I've been having a feeling that the story was going out of control. What could I do? I thought you were going to enjoy the game, but when you came together, you're not yourselves anymore. Just relax. Play ourselves and do whatever you feel like? Of course, we're family. Okay. Family, I don't think we're that close yet. You don't spend 8 hours fine-tuning weapons non-stop for non-family members. Are you talking about that time when she forced me to stay in the lab and put new parts on all the weapons? I see. No wonder I felt the weapon's cooling efficiency improved for no reason. I mean, I know this is just a little late, but thank you, Karenina. Karenina tilts her head, but is not replied immediately. She suddenly thinks of something and looks around. You guys sometimes piss me off to you. Each time I went to a base on the surface, everything nearby is completely wiped out as if it just went through saturation bombing. When you're having a bad mood, anything can piss you off. Oh, once you just found out the targets weren't too far away from the engineering force, so you just went a little further to get rid of them. See, you excluded us. I don't really mind, though. It's nice to have someone take care of these troubles for us. That's why you're a weakling, Teddy. And her hot-blooded Captain Karenina, that sounds kind of tacky, but I'm sure we'll get you famous in Babylonia as the movie's alternative title. Fuck! Just when the argument is about to end, the thundering steps are drawing near, eager to trample the area. The decision is made. Graven will move on to look for the target location. The engineering force of Strike Hawk will stay here to distract the incoming enemies. Just as you expected, the problem was resolved in no time once they had set it out. After all, you are comrades. The only thing is, I suggest we take care of the interception. Wow, you're awake. I thought our renowned Grey Raven commander had fallen asleep. Should I tell others that you were just watching them argue while doing nothing? Roll in intermediate. Intimidate. Automatic success. There you go. Don't forget to tell us what you see in the Realm of Dragons when you return. I'm quite curious. Okay. Of course. Lee runs another check on the materials collected. He separates one portion and gives it to Chrome. Once he is finished, the rest of the players watch Grey Raven disappear into the foggy alley. Well, it's our showtime now. Wait, what are those cavalries? Are there reinforcements? Are reinforcements? He looks at the direction the Karenina came from and sees lots of dust. Knights in shiny armor are holding their weapons up and inspecting the surroundings. They probably are now, thanks to someone who blew a hole in the city gate. I won't be surprised if they come all the way here. Great timing, isn't it? Now we can hold off the monsters together. Ding, ding. Ding. The familiar tone interrupts Karenina. Teddy immediately opens her terminal and displays the message on the screen. Unlike Isla's description, this text is very short. It tells the same message to all troops still in the surface conservation area. The holiday is over. Okay, I guess we have to call it a day. The players quickly check their own equipment and adjust their mindset. To them, it's not a rare experience. Unlike the world in Isla's script, they are about to plan and engage in real battle. I think we have to leave the realm of dragons to Grey Raven. As for the upcoming meeting, Captain Krone, considering the lack of manpower in the conservation area, you shouldn't rule us out again. Sure, it should be a lot easier with the engineering force joining us. Speaking of which, Teddy, can you take care of the heavy arms? We didn't have enough members to use them. Sure, just some easy target shooting practice. I'm even thinking of writing them a simple program. With the CPF around us, there's no risk of contamination. As for you, Karenina, the Shire frame will be our trump card. I propose in the meeting that you come with us to the front line. No problem. We'll fight shoulder to shoulder, just like always. Yeah, just like always. Let's go. Hey, let's go. Man, this is really fun. This is a fun story. Realm of Dragons. Let's go. You find yourself in a bizarre land, where desolation and prosperity blend together without any transition. Wither branches stand alongside lush treetops. One moment you're walking on hard, barren land, but the next instant you're on soft grass. It is impossible to determine where you are with no clear reference points. No wonder the map here still is all a mess. Commanding, we just can't keep walking like this. Shall we change our strategy? Liv, is there anything else worth noting in that hero's journal? If your luck isn't sufficient to go out, try inverting it. Remember, the Realm of Dragons welcomes all friendly adventurers. Inversing it, what would that mean? Liv looks the way you came from, trying to figure it out from there. Lucia takes the journal from her and starts to look at it from different angles. Well, Lee's inspecting the difference between different plantations. I think I get it. Lee, please lead our way. I'll do my best. Do your best indeed. It seems they have not figured it out yet. Each time they walk past a different looking region, they need to run a check until the checks return the same results. Shall I give them a hint? When the automatically calculated data is presented to Isla, she also begins to look at the results displayed on the terminal from different angles, like Lucia. Just like that, you finally got off the alternating chaos. In front of you is a city that you've never seen before. Although the buildings look very strange, you can still figure out their functions and confirm this is the Realm of Dragons. Did we make it? Wait a sec, I'd like to double check my pathfinding results. It was some sort of miracle, I would say. All successes? No, it's actually the complete opposite. All failures. Critical failures, to be exact. If your luck isn't sufficient to get you out, try inversing it. So that's what it means. Do you see this coming, Commandant? No. Let's look at the city entrance first. Isla, I mean, damn. Does this city have walls? Yes, but after searching for a while, you found a door. It is blocking your way forward. Above the door are a pair of eyes that don't belong to ordinary creatures. They are slowly opening. I want to check the items in my inventory, as well as the number of spells available. What kind of door is this? Does it open inward or outward? I want to check its texture and inspect the door hinge. It's a circle-shaped door that is large enough to be socketed into the door frame. To open it, you need to roll into the frame, but the door is currently closed and there's no point of action left for you.
The door is made from stone, with many spells cast on it to protect against lightning, wind, explosion, and so on and so forth. There's no door hinge either, so you can't break it that way. Are there any protruding rocks nearby? Maybe it's an ancient building after all. I'll climb all the way up using the protrusions then. When you climb above the door opens its mouth. You only feel a strong gale before falling backward. Can't you just knock on the door normally? I just realized they hardly open a door using the normal way. Mr. Door, you can talk? Mr. Door, thank you for giving me a name. That's probably my favorite one so far. Mr. Door, can you please let us in? We'd like to enter the Dragon Realm. Well, I don't mean to disappoint you, but I was given a duty by the guy who built me, which is to stop adventurers like you from entering. One ancient triangle replica can only let one person in. That's the rule we agreed on. We only have one replica here. How about letting the other three down? No. Come on, don't give me that serious face. You young people can't even take a joke nowadays. As long as you have the materials, I can close one eye. It's not like I never did this before. Just take it as a token of appreciation for the new name you gave me. Hey, let's go. What shall we do next then? Do we need crafting skills? No need. Just put the box with the twin souls inside into this. Mouth like opening on me. Like this? Yeah, just like that. Watch your hand now, for I'm about to extract what's inside the box. You hear the blunt noises of metal clinking, followed by the abrasive screeching made from sharp items scratching against the surface. Mr. Sword's door's stone carved face rapidly changes from relaxed to twisted in no time. Gosh, what did you put in this thing? Adamantine, obsidian, oblivion steel? Where did you get this container? It's way too chewy. Seeing Mr. Door spit out decomposed metal blocks, Liv can't help but recall Karenina's proud expression when she intrudes the box. I thought the old box wasn't secure enough, so I built a new one, made from composite materials. It can't even be used as a shield when needed. I think it can withstand the direct hit of a small caliber gun shells. Whatever, I was too confident. It's terribly rude of me. But let's just leave those things there. I don't want to dispose of them ever again. As he speaks, a loud humming sound comes from underneath as the round rock door slides to the right. I'm glad to see so many people coming from the Realm of Dragons after so long. He didn't wait so many years for nothing. Please, if you may, take care of him for me. Oh, who is he? Mr. Door did not leave you time to ask. He has returned to the doorframe and becomes silent again, just like any other ordinary door. Grey Raven crosses the stone door. They see a white crane gliding past them as they enter the wide open world from the narrow border. Okay. The city in front is nothing like the bustling jungle of steel you're used to, although not as majestic and glamorous. Its ancient bricks and wood are carved with the marks of time. Lamps light up the city like reflections of stars. Once crafted by countless people, it is having a peaceful sleep in the evening breeze. Okay. Alright. Man, this is a pretty fun chapter. Story, I won't lie. The last treasure. Let's go. Oh, Maxine 1, okay. Alright, let's go. Zim walks over to the empty streets. Shaw banners sway in the wind, shaking some dust off. They seem to be left unattended for a long time. I do have a strange feeling about this place. These lamps are all filled with lamp oil. I don't think they can last so long without maintenance. Someone seems to still be around. Can we find them? Whoever they are, I think they will stay at a place that can overlook the entire city. Taking the high ground is often the best strategy for defense, especially when there is a shortage of manpower. Put down everything you plan to take from here immediately and leave. Excuse me, are you the guardian? Do what I say now. Sorry, there must be a misunderstanding. We aren't taking anything away except... Liv, move back! The clash of blades interrupts all conversation, sending a powerful shockwave across everyone who shakes the wooden shed in disrepair.
Get out of here!
His gigantic body pushes the blade forward, forcing Lucia to fall back into an empty ground.
Okay, let's go.
Someone just passed by over there. Let's go and have a look. There we go. Alright, let's go. Should be here. Did I see it wrong? Liv, move back.
Ridiculous. You can kill me.
Get out of here.
Alright. Do you think this is how it ends? Oh shit. I don't care what obsessions you have. I'll break every one of them. Oh shit, okay. I am the guardian of the city. Your regrets will be your undoing, outsider. Oh shit.
Darn it! The countdown of despair!
Watch out, everyone!
Ridiculous! You can kill me!
He disappeared. No, he's up there. Oh shit! Okay. Come on. Graven will move forward with Commandant. All right. Okay, then. Have you calmed down, Mr. Guardian? How did you enter this city? Holding onto his sword, Realm Guardian slowly gets on his feet. He does not seem to have given up the idea of expunging the players yet. Through the city gate. He's got to be kidding me. Why is he still letting people in? Are all the rocks so stubborn like him? I can't think of any other stubborn rocks. The ancient triangle. Where did you get the key? Oh, the sage's seal in the capital. That's the only place I cannot neutralize. Triangle. Neutralize. It sounds like... You destroyed all the replicas, including the original triangle itself. The realm of dragons has lost its former glory. Everybody's hoodie has either left or disappeared. I'm the only one left in this city. Realm Guardian struggles to stand up. His majestic body and weapon have become one. They spent a lot of effort establishing the city. I will protect this place no matter what. Leave, heroes. There's no good old or treasure in the Realm of Dragons now. It is not worth your time or effort. Mr. Guardian, we didn't come here for treasure or gold. Are you history scholars then? Unfortunately, I will not let you take a single brick away. Why do we have to take something? We traveled so long to get here. Are you saying this journey is only a price we must pay for the treasure? But that's not your end goal, is it? I don't think that is everything, Mr. Guardian. Guardian? Our journey has its own meaning. Even if we end up with no treasure at all. How ridiculous. That is only a waste of time. Oh, shit. Mr. Guardian, do you remember a group of heroes who once came to the Realm of Dragons? Among them was a wizard who liked to cover his own face. A group of heroes, the wizard covering his face, of course I remember them. The guy took away the last gold coin in the Realm of Dragons. He left with almost nothing. We met him not long ago. Liv takes out the bottle of sleepy fog, while Liv leaves the strong short staff with the teleport spell inside. He gave us these to thank our help. He also asked us to pass a message. I couldn't answer back then, but now I can tell the Guardian with great certainty. After so many years, we are still best friends. That's why I'll never regret the journey to look for the Realm of Dragons.
Oh, damn. Okay. Realm Guardian's hands paused for a moment. His attacking stance gradually relaxed as Lucius spoke. Mr. Guardian, is it true that our journey ends at the Realm of Dragons? You could call our effort to retrieve the treasure of the Realm of Dragons ridiculous, but please don't deny our time spent together. That is the most precious experience and cannot be measured with anything else. Even if you return empty-handed? Liv did not answer, but exchanged a look with other Grey Raven members. They all nod together. See, I told you, you could care about the result. You care about the results too much. Mr. Door? A gigantic stone disc thunders down the hill, making an even louder bang. After crashing through a fence and a wooden banner, he finally ends up in the collapsed wall. With his face upside down, he looks back at the trail he left. Oops, that was a few meters off. I can totally give that an 8. Realm Guardian looks bitterly at the mess, wishing he could wield Mr. Door into the crack. Weld Mr. Door into the crack he left. I'll turn you into a wall if you ever do this again. Relax, you have plenty of time. I think the heroes have a point. Don't get too hung up on the Realm of Dragons. They built this city from scratch. This is the legend that all adventurers long for. Can you really watch all of this become a joke? Mr. Guardian? That wizard didn't tell anyone the actual situation in the Realm of Guardians. I think he also wants to search for the Realm of Dragons to last forever. Also wants the Realm of Dragons to last forever, so more people will meet their friends and embark on this journey together. I guarded the entrance to the Realm of Dragons for so many years, but I never seen anyone abandon their friend because of that stupid one triangle for one person only rule. Is that why you're away from your position? I was about to hold off the hostility from outside, not to stop people inside from going out. Damn, okay. Experience the outside world. Look at it with your own eyes. If someone is willing to stay, just let them stay as long as they pass my check. This place doesn't have to end, even if we are no longer around. The city may have declined, but I'm sure it will soon be revitalized upon the arrival of new friends. It really got me a big task. Whatever. Realm Guardian throws something to Liv. You win. Take this as a souvenir. Don't put it in a temple like others. What's this? Twin souls. Mr. Guardian, may I ask how to make this type of item? Without them, the monsters would... Since when does it have such a function? Well, I've never heard of that. If that's the case, the monsters didn't attack in the past because... Realm Guardian scratches his head, trying to recall something. From what I recall, the people who lived there were busy building a temple to hold the souvenirs they brought from the Realm of Dragons. Fear they stopped expanding their territory and left the monsters undisturbed. Naturally, the monsters didn't go to them for revenge. Okay then. Wow, okay. So it was basically the power of friendship. Okay then. Alright, let's move on to the next stage. Off the stage. After bidding farewell to Mr. Door, the team has returned to the place outside the city. According to Isla, everyone needs to return to the city or the village to put an end to their hero journey. Commander, what would heroes do after completing their duties? Do what they want to do, probably. Just like the adventure never happened, heroes return to their home and open the dusted door with a key they haven't used for a long time. Or will they spend another long journey with friends? Will we ever see that day? Honestly, it's a difficult question. Hey, is it over? Cerberus seems to be waiting for a long time. They walk out of the shadow and confront Grey Raven, with Vera staying in the front. Okay, hey. I need to remind you that the main mission is complete. Does that mean we are dismissed? Sorry, Vera. Didn't know that Cerberus was also in the game, so... I think you got me wrong. Hmm? The Vera points her blade to you all. I'm here for the treasure. Sorry, we don't have it. The realm of dragons is nothing but an empty shell. Gold coins? Nope. Mission rewards? Neither. What did you get then? Grey Raven members look at one another. They only smile without answering. Fine, whatever. Let's just start the battle. Battle? Vera, we don't need to fight. The mission in the Realm of Dragons is over. Mission? Cerberus never took anything like that. We just feel like that killing the hero team is more fun than doing routine missions. Wait! When Vera and her team are about to attack, some familiar figures stand in front of Grey Raven. Sticks hero wizard and his friends. Wizard! As a former hero, I'll never allow such a thing to happen. Because I am their friend. Haha, I thought we were having some tough opponents. Turns out it was you. Did you drag Grey Raven into this because you were scared of my revenge? Who the fuck is this? Anyway, my comrades will never let you hurt the heroes. Are you still not punished for that month? Hey, let's go. Despite his words, the knight still holds up his shield and stands in the very front. Me too. The Traveling Wizards team is not the only party here. Riding on war horses, the remaining members of the expedition also come to the rear of Cerberus. I never thought riding a horse could be so challenging. Just looking at the simulated graphics alone drives me dizzy. It's Commandant Simon. Dark Ares is here too. Why is there so much red text in Simon's status bar? Don't worry, as long as I keep rolling critical successes, won't die. Even if you do, our mission is probably already completed anyway. Speaking of which, who should write the mission report if Captain dies? You've been following us all along, but we just couldn't get rid of you. I will give you credit for that. But it's time to call it a day, isn't it? Noctis knocks his fist together and stands in front of Dark Ares. Number 21 summons a cobalt and looks like a Grey Raven from behind the knight. Excuse me, heroes. Hmm? You look like you already know them for a long time. May I ask about your relationship? It's quite complicated. But it's actually not hard to understand. We're all comrades. Hmm? Just like that, the battle begins. After so many years, the Realm of Dragons becomes lively again among the magic and explosions. Our heroes will continue to embark on a future journey with their friends. Okay then. Okay. Well, okay then. Well, damn. Okay. This is just getting crazy by the minute. In the name of comrades. Well, let's finish it off. Isla finished her script. After another round of the game, all the players received their WGAA's invitation. The project has come to the most crucial part. It is very exciting in Babylonia. Members from different forces and squads have all gathered in the studio managed by WGAA. Noctis, those two lanterns need to be a little higher. Alright, I'll lift them up. What are you doing? Number 21 is holding two candles up high on tippy toes, trying to reach the lantern in Noctis' hand. I want to put them inside the lantern. Just wait for me to finish hanging the lantern first. Buddy, go. Number 21 gives the candles to her cobalt. Noctis tries to cast it away, but it continues to climb up Noctis' head. Hey, what are you doing? Watch out, I can't see! With a candle in each hand, Noctis cannot take the cobalt off himself. I used to use all the feats on this on that sword attack. Super critical, super strength, and every roll is critical success. It's been a long time since they ever had such a powerful attack in the system record. Yeah, it landed right on my face. 48 damage. That couldn't even take my body off the, they couldn't even take my body off the ground. Who would have thought I rolled a critical fail and then hit check? Was that lucky or unlucky? Kamui is helping Wanchi put on a bush costume. Rumor has it that in a subsequent patch, Wanchi managed to stay stealth in the area for 7 days thanks to this camouflage. When he woke up, he successfully defeated the Demon King while on patrol. Why was Wanchi able to one-shot the Demon King, but I wasn't allowed to? Probably because you were using a gun while I was using a crossbow. You call that thing a crossbow? It's a ballista, and it takes up more space than you. What are you going to do with the wall? Should I make a simple replica to replace it? Inside the room? Did you just learn performance art from the WGAA? I'll build a scaffold then. Special effects alone won't be enough. Don't worry, my effects are flawless with Isla's guidance. In front of the terminal used for scene simulation and After Effects, Karenina and Teddy are discussing the performance. Liv walks to them and hands over a few rice dumplings. We plan to give them out as a festival souvenirs after the performance. Can you please taste them and let us know if there are any improvement that can be made? Isla looks at the joyful scene. Occasionally, she would also stop tapping on the terminal and chuckle. I call that a great success. Yeah! They've always been fighting together, but sometimes they still ignore each other. It's a strange feeling. Maybe that's just what friends are. There may be some misunderstanding in the beginning, but eventually everything will turn out to be alright. Still, I think it's important to voice out our feelings. It's crucial for us to realize and acknowledge the importance of our friends. You nod without answering. The center of the room has become a noisy sight. Karenina and Teddy are arguing again. Number 21 is holding her cobot and running between others to run from Noctis. Lee and Wanchi are discussing where to place the ballista. Before you realize it, you already have so many comrades to fight alongside. Commandant! It is time to dress up as an apple tree. Lucia is calling you with a smile. I shouldn't have used the camouflage skill in the story. Isla takes a step forward, then turns sideways and reaches out to you. Let's go, Commandant. Everyone is waiting. Alright, I'm sure we'll get busier later, so I'll say this to you now. Happy Dragon Ball Festival, Commandant. Aw, thanks. Aw, thanks. That was cute. That story was cute, man. That was a cute-ass story, I won't lie. Yeah, that was a cute-ass story, I won't lie. I enjoyed it. I really did enjoy it. It was cute. I enjoyed it. It was a nice, you know, thing to relax, you know, just have a bit of fun. You know, be goofy a bit. I liked that. I liked it. Overall, it was just a fun, non-deep story. And that's alright. And I liked it. But yeah, with that said, I think that's where I'm going to end stream here for today. So yeah. It's been a bit of a long one, but, yeah. Thank you guys again so much for tuning in. Be sure to drop a like and a subscribe and a follow. And also be sure to comment what you thought down in the comments below. And remember to stay humble and be kind to people. I'll see you guys later.